We're putting the band back together.
Forget it. No way.
We're on a mission from God.
Hey there. Welcome back to the Kel-n-rich Show. My name is Kel, and this is my wonderful, amazing husband and musical tour guide, Rich. And he is here to give me another musical surprise for the night.
Right back to the beginning. I'm talking like the beginning, like the first night. The first night where we turned on...
Dream Theater.
I did not tell her to wear the shirt.
No, I wore it because I love this shirt. That's why.
Right back to when I said, you know what? I want to send our friend Chris.
Hi, Chris.
Our reaction to the new album, and at that point, this was what, 2019, mm-hmm. right? Shortly after Jared passed away.
Yeah.
And little did we know we were going to get so many comments and so much feedback because this guy did not know how to do unlisted. And did the post publicly on YouTube, and that started the show. So yeah. I figured, what a better way to kick off the first night.
Thank you.
We started with let your ears kind of gently be eased back into the music with
warm them up a little bit.
A little bit of kind of light prog with mystery, some ethereal stuff, beautiful
so
stuff.
Good.
A song called "How Do You Feel." Wonderful. So check that out. And this one is Awaken the Master. This is on the other side of your journey on your way back, Kel. And
there's a monster that's been woken up. All right.
There's a lot to say about that, I'm sure. So stick around to the until the end.
There's no script here.
We're just basically turning the lights on in our house, in our studio, and having some fun and sharing the music with you. Maybe it's new for you. This one is... from a View from the Top of the World from 2021. Kel has not heard a lick of the album, and I figured this would be a good one to start with, considering the lyrics, considering want to get her kind of, her engine revved up again, right?
Let's
do it. So welcome, guys. I'm glad you're here. Going back to Dream Theater. No, it's not going to be the same music all the time. We're not going to do we're not going to do Megadeth and Metallica and Slayer. We're not going to always do that stuff. We're going to go back to the literally million requests that we have. And we have a little search engine that we're going to be referring to, the Patreon requests that we had from 2019, 2020. We're going to just get back into it. Watch the last video to have more of an explanation on what's been going on.
And just so we understand, my ability to listen to music has only come back in the last 2 weeks. So heavy, heavy music, we're not even sure if I'll be able to take it because I have sensitivity to sound and light from the concussions from the pitbull attack. So we'll have to just see how it goes song by song. So we're just, like Rich said, very gently easing me back into it, even putting headphones on.
Yeah. So this one's Dream Theater, so it's pretty technical. There's lots of different, movements and progressions, and I'm sure there's going to be, lots of keyboard runs and things like that. And hopefully, worst comes to worst, guys, if you see me do this with a microphone, it just means I'm turning it down for her.
Yeah.
Okay, that's really it. Hopefully she won't have to take her headphones off like in the past, when we had some starts and stops after the attack, that she survived like a champ. So let's just see how it goes. And yeah, I chose this one really for the lyrics. I heard it once, just... I wanted to see if Kel could listen to music again. If we get back to the show, let's start back with Dream Theater. That was the idea. I think it's going to be good. And I really don't remember the song. I just remember that I have a list, and it says Season 3, Rich's Picks. So here we go.
Well, thanks. And thanks for being here, everybody. Looking forward to reading all your comments and getting back to playing with all of you. And you too.
All right. Thank you, my love. Ooh, just have to get back. And I just need, one of your amazing, profound sound effects. And okay. I'm ready on the button. Okay, ready? There it is. All right. we're going to do our best to not block the video or the video not block us here. We'll see how it goes. We're still rusty. All right, here we go.
I love Dream Theater. Oh.
Count that out.
Very good. Thank you.
Say this, his drums finally sound like he's kind of with the band fully. Super tight, super dynamic. Something's coming.
You made it
vocals
to the top. Just to find out you're only halfway there.
good. All good.
Changes. Oh, God, drums. Holy shit. Monster on this track. He's just a monster on this track.
Yeah. Yeah.
Whole album, I remember just sampling it. The vocals are great.
It's great. Turning the stone, circles of darkness and light.
She's awoken. She's awakening. She's awake.
Okay. Oh, oops. Sorry. Okay. Wow. That was fantastic. Holy doodle.
Count that one out, Kel.
Okay, I just got to say something. So in the past, when we were doing this with all of you, a lot of you know that I would close my eyes because I often felt that the video was highly distracting. Because I am what is called, I'm autotelic, which means that I am a hyperfocuser. So I only ever do one thing at a time, or I don't do it well. So I would never be the kind of kid who tried to watch TV, read a book, do homework, and have a telephone conversation.
I'm the total opposite.
Right. So he knows he's been...
Squirrel.
Right. And I'm very focused when I do things. Even when I do the dishes, it's all I'm doing. I'm not thinking about anything else. I'm just trying not to cut myself with a knife. Because we've been having some serious coordination problems with the right side. So, something's different, though.
What's different, Kel?
Well, I have been, in the last 28 months since this all started, I have been not able to exercise or do anything. I've led the life of a one-armed invalid hermit, basically, because that's all I could take. And as my injuries have slowly been getting better and I've been getting over surgeries and anesthesia and all this stuff, I have been working on the only thing that I really could, which is my heart and my soul, because it was really the only thing I had control over, because I couldn't even use my right arm. I mean, it just hung at my side for the better part of, 18 months, like a slab of flesh. It just wouldn't move. So I'm hearing things differently because I haven't listened to any music because I just couldn't take it.
We sold Susie. Every time she would look at that beautiful mini grand digital piano, she would just get sad, like really sad. She would try to sit down and play at it and it would hurt like hell. And it was just like one day I just said, Kel, is it okay if I sell Susie? And she just said, thank you. I was like, ugh. Yeah, one day we could have, she could have gotten back to it. But at this point, it's not possible yet. And that's just one of the things that we just chose to do. You make some hard choices.
And as musicians, those of you that are musicians, I have had many pianos in my lifetime. They come and they go in your life. And there is a time to play and a time not to play and to just have her... just sit there and look at her and her beautiful rhinestone stars and just broke my heart.
Yeah.
It was better to just send her somewhere else.
So you're hearing, what'd you hear differently? Let's get to the song.
So the thing is watching the video was not distracting me. I was actually, aren't you shocked? I was actually able to concentrate on the music and enjoy the music and enjoy the video. That never happens.
Wow.
Usually I'm like, oh God, the video, God, I just can't do both.
Yes.
So
we remember.
It's not that the videos are awful. It's that I just can't concentrate on two things at one time, but that's changing. Because when we were at the concert, I was able to listen to the music and enjoy the people around me and focus on...
That's true. You did mention that.
So it's changing. So tonight is the first time I've tried to watch a music video since whenever the last one that we did here on the channel.
There are no accidents.
This is true.
Speaking of kind of bringing you up to speed, I had kidney cancer. That was a surprise. That happened... Yep. That happened last...
A year ago.
Yeah, it was about a year ago. It was like I was checking out my herniated discs. I was a wrestler and a pitcher and just a maniac. And I wanted to just check up and see how my discs were doing. And lo and behold, a great team of doctors and chiropractors kind of said, hey, Rich, something came back on the report. It's a little shadow that the radiologist saw. After a while, we discovered that it was a pretty decent size renal cell carcinoma on the right side. And it wasn't like, oh my God, Rich, come in tomorrow, you need surgery, but you probably don't want to wait until Christmas kind of thing. So I had robotic a robotic partial nephrectomy. So the doctor was there with all of his kind of doodads and things, and the robot was doing its thing and poking holes in me and pulling out, excising the tumor. It was small enough that I only lost 10% of my kidney. And I sent Kel a video of me and with, the little gown that he ties in the back. Well, I didn't tie it. And
fresh out of surgery.
The iPhone may have done one of these.
You know, cheeky. It was very cheeky. It was a cheeky video.
The recovery was fantastic, and I was back to work in like 5 weeks. I couldn't really lift anything heavy, so I wasn't. I would tell my clients, "Okay, you got to lift that. Okay, now not only do you have to lift it, you have to lift it 12 times, and then you got to put it back." Or before I would, help them with the weights, or I'd lift their legs if they're on the table and I'm doing body work, and like, "Can you lift your leg?" Because I really wasn't supposed to do anything for that area. And then lo and behold. Besides, let's see, my brother, Bruce, committed suicide on July
31st. Just after I was attacked by the dog.
Right after she got attacked by the dog. My best friend, Jay, from Vancouver, passed away from
kidney cancer
kidney cancer as well.
In December.
Yeah, he told us 6 weeks before that he was sick, and then, poof, he's out of here. And a bunch of other things personally, but then... On Sunday, so Saturday this was the Allison Chains.
Sunday.
This Sunday was the Allison Chains concert, okay?
4 days ago. 4 days ago.
Breaking Benjamin Bush. We're having a great time. We start the channel. We're like, we're back. Literally that morning, I'm setting up the studio right here. This was kind of the vision, right? Just like, well, let's put it in front of the pinball machines and put some stuff up that we love. And I sat here and I pressed some sort of button, and all of a sudden my left side went like that. I'm like, what the hell? I got up. I went to the kitchen.
Almost passed out.
I was like, oh, this is not good. And then
we spent the day in emergency.
Well, before that, I was rolling on that floor in absolute excruciating agony.
Yeah.
You can, for those of you who have had it before or have heard about it, you know what it was. It was a kidney stone, and it was lodged in there. And it wasn't huge. It was 3 millimeters. So you're talking about that big. But if you haven't seen a kidney stone, it looks like Jor-El, something that Jor-El would have created in the Fortress of Solitude. It would be the little crystals and shards. That's like a kidney stone.
He's a little fogged out because he just had surgery yesterday.
So I had surgery yesterday for this.
And emergency room Sunday, hospital Monday, which was an absolute nightmare of an experience.
Yeah. So hospital on Sunday for the immediate. Oh my God! Kel got me into the car and we went across the street to the hospital.
Spent the whole day there.
Yep. Spent the whole day there. Discharged me, sent me home with some pain meds. Didn't work. Went to my urologist on Monday morning. The urologist said, "What the fuck are you doing here? Get to the hospital. You need surgery. I can't do anything for you." So went to one hospital. They're full. COVID and also the Florida hurricane. Hurricane Ian just came through. So there's been a lot of switching of staff and things. So I'm like, shit. So we got into the car and we went to the hospital that I had my kidney cancer surgery at. Now, this is where it gets really bad. I didn't want Kel to stay and wait because we have the dogs at home and, she's still recovering herself and it was going to be kind of a long wait. Well, the Percocet and the stuff that they gave me didn't work, and I was told based on my symptoms, I mean, I'm like in agony, that I was next in priority.
This is bad.
3 hours in the chair. And I, at one point, it was like an hour after I was there, I said to one of the orderlies or whoever was monitoring the waiting room. This was at Boca Regional, by the way. And it's a great hospital, but that day, it wasn't so good in the emergency room. I said, "You got to keep an eye on me because I think I'm going to pass out from the pain. It's like a 12 out of 10. And she says, "Well, would you like anything?" I said, I'd like to actually be seen and treated and given some Dilaudid or something, because that worked at the last hospital I was in. And then I got sent out of there, and now I'm back here. 3 hours. I passed out from the pain for some period of time. 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes. I don't know. I woke up. I didn't know if I had just like had a near-death experience, like I kind of died and came back, you know, like, come back, Rich, there's still more to do. Don't go to the light, Rich. Go to the chair. And
go to the doctor.
I with all the strength that I had, I kind of scanned the room and I saw the lady that was supposed to be watching out for me. And I said, you, it felt like doing you. Yes, you stand still, laddie. But anyway, I didn't do that. I said, you get over here. I said, you get over here. I thought you were going to watch me. I just passed out. I need emergency medical attention right the hell now. Right now, or I'm going to start rolling on the floor in agony, making a big scene, and I think I'm going to piss my pants because it's that painful. She brought me back, and they got, you know, they attended to me, and I stayed that night because the surgeon couldn't do it. It was 7 hours between, so I was in the chair for 3 hours, then I waited in the emergency bed with the dilaudid and stuff like that, and I was feeling better. And it was 7 hours, so it was beyond the surgeon's time, so I had to stay overnight. And then the next morning,
which was yesterday morning,
and I had surgery at like 12 o'clock, and I got out at 3 o'clock. At one point, I remember this, at the when they brought me to, when they woke me up from my anesthesia coma, I apparently sat up like a zombie. And they're like, Mr. Gafter, you got to lie down. And I remember this. And what was going on for me, what you don't know about me, is I'm a high-level pickleball player now. And in my mind, there was a net in front of me, and the ball was dropping into the kitchen, and I needed to get the ball on the, you know, before it hits the second bounce. And so I sat up, and I'm with this racket in my hand, and I'm doing this. And they thought that I was, like, trying to punch things, and I was just trying to get to the little plastic fucking yellow ball. So they're pushing me down, and it took four of them to push me down. I remember that. And finally I said, all right, I'll lose the point. And they're just like, what are you doing? And I said, pickleball. They said, just relax. You just woke up from anesthesia. Just relax. And then I kind of remember talking to the nurse and stuff. But anyway, I was discharged 3 hours later. I walked out of the hospital, and here we are, basically the next day. So anyway, that's the long story of quite an episode. So yeah,
when we say it's been a crazy 28 months, it's been a crazy 28
we're
months.
Probably not special or different.
No,
it just, there's things that have,
it's
happened,
not,
that,
it's just, it's been full.
Yeah,
it's been full,
and it's cool to share stories. And you know, a lot of you we've gotten to know, and I think it was important that I let you know that I survived around cancer. And yeah, this is the stuff that's been going on. And feel free to share what's going on in the comments down below for you. Just a little check-in. We see a lot of familiar names. We have almost 83,000 subscribers now. We're getting between 500 and 1,000 over the absence. People were watching our videos and just kind of digging what we were doing. And how can we not come back? And we fought to come back.
We did.
So
thank
there
you
we
for
go.
Waiting.
And I just want to say something just to finish up with the song. You can take or leave James LaBrie's vocals, okay? I happen to like him as a singer.
Me too.
And a lot of people bust on him. You know, it was a great song until the lyrics, and I keep saying that, until the vocals started. Some songs, I could see that it probably would have been better as an instrumental. But James sings his heart out, and he's passionate, and he's just a force. And on this song, I think he just killed it. And I thought Jordan with the keyboards was absolutely awesome.
Yes.
Sometimes I can find his runs a little bit runny. And I found that, you know, Mangine's, you know, him replacing Portnoy has been really tricky, I would imagine. And on this album in particular, I think he really found his place, and he sounds amazing, like amazing. Can't wait to do the other songs from the album, and John Petrucci, and the bass was
great. I feel like Sleeping Beauty, you know? I feel like I've been asleep for a long time now, and I'm just waking up And these headphones are not different. This microphone is not different, but it all sounds different inside my head.
Wow.
And I don't know what that means yet, except that it's really, really good.
More. We'll get to some of your suggestions. We're going to try to, for some reason, I just want to say this, and yeah, the video is going a little long, and that's okay. You can leave or you can stay. I look back on Patreon today, and we had 100 kind of inner circle members.
Yeah.
And for some reason, Patreon did not keep the messages that were sent back and forth, especially where we asked for your requests. And there's not many left, of course, because we weren't producing any content, and that's completely fair. I just wanted to keep the site up because people said, we want to be able to support you guys. We don't know how to do it. You've put out a lot of content. Even if it's $2 a month, I want to give it to somewhere. So we created a Patreon page and had some fun with that. And it proved to be a little bit tricky because Patreon videos were getting blocked. It was just like, oh my God, yeah, I can't deal with the whole block thing. So we just kept it going with no content. But I don't know what your requests are. So if you still are around on Patreon or if you want to find our page, it's just Kel-n-rich Patreon. I'll be able to link up the fact that you were one of our first. I printed out the...
Oh, yeah. I wondered what that was.
Yeah, I printed out the log, and it shows when everyone joined, you know, what their numbers were.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, so I'll be able to pick out those first 100 and then, you know, get to some of those requests. And just know that Kel-n, I really appreciate it. She wasn't working. I was barely working through COVID. So anything that you gave went to us surviving, just like a lot of you.
Thank you.
So thank you so much. And we'll do our best to get to requests and answer your emails and things. But just know that there's an enormous amount. And it doesn't make your input or your contribution less significant. Just imagine the task. So if you want to Facebook us, Richard Gafter, Kel doesn't keep her Facebook active. Or you can email us at kelnrichg, so kelnrichg @gmail.com, or send us a letter.
My Facebook page is up there, but I'm still having trouble navigating my phone using my right arm. So I don't spend a lot of time on technology. Yeah. Like, I can't type and I can't use the mouse. So
yeah, if you messenger me,
yeah,
Kel, you know, when we're in bed, we'll read some of the comments and I'll respond to you guys. Facebook, we're having fun with, and we'll certainly look at the comments in down below on YouTube.
All right.
So that's it. So welcome back. Welcome the heck back, Kel.
Thank you, and you too.
Thank you.
And you too. Thanks for a great pick. Loved it.
We're going to do some more, I think.
I know we are, because guess what? I can listen to music again.
Ah! I think I just came up with an idea, and we're going to do it next. It's going to really complete the circle, and it's going to be a type of music that you've been listening to, and I think I have the band that might be a good complement to what you've been listening to.
Okay.
Stick around.
All right. Thanks for being here.
Later.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
We happy?
Yeah, we happy.